We just had a misunderstanding.
We had a misunderstanding at first.
Can you repeat that back?
Well, the question was, Apostle Attar said a question to the brothers. He asked all the Israelite world, basically, what did Isaac mean when he told Esau that you shall break the yoke of your brother, like you shall burst the yoke of your brother. Talking about Genesis 27. I had mistakenly, thinking that he was talking about Jacob breaking the yoke, but he was talking about Esau breaking the yoke. So I'm gonna just go over it. And then however the spirit goes. But this was going to what the brother was talking to about the sword too though. But this is Genesis 27. I'm gonna start at 35. And he said, thy brother, Salak. And he said, thy brother came with subtlety and has taken away thy blessing. And he said, is not he rightly named Jacob? For he have supplanted me these two times. He took away my birthright, and behold, now he has taken away my blessing.
And if I might add though right quick, that's Esau for you, man. Acting like a bitch, talking about Jacob took away his birthright. Nigga, you sold it. This nigga crying to, he's lying to his father, man. Lying on his brother. He been lying on us since the fucking beginning, man. Lying to his father, talking about he took my birthright.
You sold it to him,
man.
Especially like Amalek. Yeah. Like, they always exaggerate shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like even like let's just say I just like if I shove someone, he'll just say like I knock someone out.
Yeah.
Or like there was this one one of my classmates like back in like grade school, he was probably like an Amalekite and all that. And he would always come up with all these stories about I think they're gonna he said like another classmate like the mafia was after him and shit like that. And it turns out that all he was doing like was just moving to another state, for example. Alright, better example is this incident. You know the two men and two women, those two four teenagers that kidnapped that Edomite.
The two girls, they were like in their
20s.
But the two guys were teenagers, they were like 18, 19.
But the thing is like that's not all like they didn't all like he made it out alive. They're gonna throw the book at him. And then it's like a couple years ago, remember that picture of that guy that was like hung?
Mm-hmm.
Just like shit like that.
Yeah, no, what about all the kidnapping you did, Esau? And to us.
Hey, because
we don't speak home.
In the same fucking state of Illinois, man. You know, these fucking Edomites had kidnapped two Jakes, man. No, and they killed them and everything, had sex with their dead corpse and shit. That shit didn't even make the fucking news though. In the same fucking state, man. You know? But hey.
Go ahead, no. It's like they were just talking about how they let the white dude off with like probation for raping the dude with a hanger. He raped the dude with a hanger, and there ain't no outrage about that.
Not only did he rape him, he beat him and shit.
Yeah, but they mad about slapping a little white. I guess he mentally disabled.
They wasn't doing shit. They was in that bitch smoking weed, having fun. Only they was drinking. They was chilling. They wasn't really doing nothing to that white boy, bro.
Hey, Esau, fucking bitch, stole a whole nation of people.
Yeah.
A whole nation.
Hey, if you can read that little part back about him, when he said that.
No sweat. Yeah, come on. This is back in Genesis 27, verse 35. And he said, thy brother came with subtlety and has taken away thy blessing. And he said, is not he rightfully named Jacob? For he has supplanted me these two times. he took away my birthright, and behold, now he had taken away my blessing.
Right, so he lying to his father right then, man. Talk about Jacob took away his birthright and took away his blessing, man. This Psalms 50:19, it says, thou givest thy mouth to evil, and thy tongue frameth deceit, man. You know, that's Esau, man. It says, thou sittest and speakest against thy brother. Thou slanderest thine own mother's son. Right. You know, so that's what he was doing since the beginning of time, man. Slandering his own mother's son, man. Hey, like the scripture say, man, he accuses us day and night, man.
Real
you know?
Quick, can you bring out 2 Matthew 7?
Switch out. Somebody want to switch out.
All right. 2 Maccabees 7.
Switch out with God.
We only got like 45 minutes left. Shit, we're gonna go an hour.
That's cool. We're gonna end it.
I got you.
Mm-hmm.
36 say, for our
brother, yeah, that's a lot. Mm-hmm. Once the brother, he speak the truth. Jacob didn't steal anything. Esau sold it, man. He sold it. Why? Why? And why did he sell it? Because he was out there hunting, you know?
He sold it because he a piece of shit.
He a piece of shit,
you know? And he ain't really care about the meaning of his birthright, man. This is the seriousness of it.
Well, I want to go, well, what was he doing that day, though? Because he despised it, but what kind of shit he was doing that day? He was doing things that you should have ought to be doing anyway. Messing with nature, you know, killing animals for sport, man. That's against the script. You don't just kill something for no reason. You know, a family of deers, that's something precious right there. You just don't kill the mother.
Yeah,
and then slay the kid and leave the father just out there.
The scriptures say too, even with the trees, you don't destroy all the trees that can be beneficial to you. Only the ones that don't really bear fruit.
Yeah, because what is venison though? Because that's what he was going to get. Right. But then here the thing is, his father, Isaac, he's rich, man. He's rich in cattle, he's rich in gold and all that shit. You already had me. No? So that's right.
Go ahead. You got it. Set up by the spirit of the Lord, and his mother knew that.
That's what I said. The angel had gave her the prophecy that the elder shall serve the younger. So she was really trying to carry out the prophecy that the angel gave her.
Yeah. This Maccabees, 2 Maccabees 7:31, it says, and thou hast been the author of all mischief against the Hebrews, shalt not escape the hands of the Most High.
Kind, that's talking about Esau. He's been the author of this shit. Like, he the one who cheated and came up with all type of shit to do all type of wickedness and cruel punishments to us. And like you said, he made us alligator bait. Shit like that, just hanging us. They just had Jake hanging off of trees and like the community just sitting there watching this shit. Just in the middle of the city, and they just standing around to watch till they get tired and shit.
Well, did y'all see that about what is that, Mexico? They said the gas went up.
That's why they're doing that shit.
They like a gallon of gas going to be like 20.
Hey, I'm going to jump to verse 34. It says, without, O godless man, and of all other most wicked, be not lifted up without a cause, nor puffed up with uncertain hopes, lifting up thy hand against the servants of the Most High.
Kind of, that's what they did without a cause. Like, shit, they still do that to this day. Just do that, just go kill Jake just for fun. Go lynch Jake. I seen a video of these two Edomites at a gas station. I guess they got into it with the Jake inside the store. They went and ran Jake down in a goddamn Jeep. Chased this nigga in the Jeep and just ran him down. He ran him from zigzagging across the street and they ran this nigga over. Like, they just do this shit for fun.
Verse 35, it says, for thou hast not yet escaped the judgment of Almighty Yahweh, who seeth all things.
So you ain't got away with it just for this moment in time, just because you think you're getting away with it, or just because you ain't getting punished still for what you did from 400 years ago from our previous captivity. Just because you ain't never got punished for that, don't mean you got away with it. You can set up for a point in time. Most high, he gonna make sure you get paid back.
Keep going on that, brother.
Come on, yep. Then it say,
make your point, you know, you should be making a point.
Yeah, kind of, right. So it's a verse 38, and it say, and Esau said unto his father, verse 38, and Esau said unto his father, has thou, hey, can you just hold y'all?
Genesis 27 and 38. It says, and Esau said unto his father, hast thou but one blessing, my father? Bless me, even me also, oh my father. And Esau lifted up his voice and wept.
So that's when he wept, you know, he was crying, emotional, and
keep going.
Yeah,
Verse 39, it says, and Isaac his father answered and said unto him, behold, thy dwelling shall be the fatness of the earth, right, and of the dew of heaven from above.
So the fatness of the earth, that's why Esau live in these luxury places. So here we are in Cleveland. These so-called white people live in Brandon Hall, Pepper Pike,
Beachwood,
Chardon. In the heavens, you know, they got the airplanes, you know, they got the satellites. They, that's part of their blessings, you know.
Huh.
They got the painting up the penthouses up the Tower City, you know. They got these high towers, you know. That's part of their blessings.
Keep going. Mm-hmm. Verse 40, it says, and by thy sword shalt thou live.
Right, so by the sword, their guns, like we said earlier, their first gun was the Gatling gun, you know, which they used to basically slaughter the Reubens, which mm-hmm. is the Native Americans, the Native Indians and the mm-hmm. and the Seminole Indians, which is Gad, and which is Native, and and Reuben is a Seminole, which means the runaway.
And that major sword is a military might.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, come on.
They four branches of the military, armies and shit like that. That's how they live, man. You know, they go in every fucking, like they over there in Aleppo, Syria, man, bombing the shit out of them, man. Because they want something that those Syrians have, man. You know?
Yeah, so I can chime in on that too, because everything is carnal and, spiritual. The brother, one of the elders, was going into, they swore also being like the media, trying to throw down and slander us too, you know, the Israelites or what have you, because like the brother was going into that little Chicago shit, he was like, those just four dumb two-thirds, man, but what they did ain't as harsh as what Esau did to us, so they used they sword being a media, you know, to try to throw down and slander us and give us a bad name.
After y'all, scarf.
Hey, lady, ma'am.
That's the car.
They real intention is to try to do away, but now they getting a reason. You know what I'm saying? Now they giving a reason to want to already do harm, even though they've been doing it since the beginning of time.
That's the spirit, though, that you said that, because that media, that shit is a sword. Because the sword is an instrument of war, and you can start wars with what you say, man. You know, like the scripture.
You know that that one saying, like, the pen is better than the sword.
Oh, come. Yeah.
It was a newspaper with Donald Trump, and it had two different titles. The same pictures, all the other articles on both sides were still like the same, but the titles were misleading for two different areas. You know what I'm saying?
You need a flyer?
Yeah.
Slack it.
You got it.
Come. So finish, read that part over again. All
right.
So the brother made a good point about the sword being the war, the media, gun, the technology, Esau, that's part of his blessing. So keep on.
Yeah, come. Genesis 27 and 40, and by thy sword shalt thou live, and shalt serve thy brother.
Uh-huh.
And it shall come to pass, when thou shalt have the dominion, that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck.
All right, get Revelation 20. So we're going to see. It say that Tom and Esau shall break the yoke that we got on. So it was a part of history that One time we had Esau in start at one.
Okay.
Then we had Esau in a chokehold. You know, we was ruling and Esau was under our feet. He was serving us. Yeah, we gonna bring that out.
Revelations 20:1.
Uh-huh.
And I saw an angel come down from heaven, having the key of the bottomless pit.
No, that angel, one of them angels, you know, well, major man was named Septimius Severus, right? He was a he was an Israelite that you know, basically if you saw the movie the Gladiator, that was they were talking about him, you know. And what he did was basically he conquered Rome. He infiltrated, you know, he won his freedom, but he became basically one of the heads of Rome. He basically started running the Roman Empire. And the Roman Empire wasn't just in Italy, it was Providence. You know, they had a mass of you know,
They ran Egypt.
They ran parts of the east. If we get the map, real quick, if we can find the map, I can show you.
Yeah, it's just like it is currently today. How they have the military branches branched off in every country. How they got bases everywhere. Everybody land. That's the same way.
How they had it back then, man. It wasn't just, we just run Italy, man. Roman was a dominant power. They ran all this, man. They spread their armies, you know. So they had garrisons, like embassies, in all these places, you know. So they ran all this, so, you know.
Yeah. Any place that you occupy, you can run that shit. Just like America, man.
Yeah.
They owe 800 occupancies that they got occupied across the fucking world, man. Wherever they occupy that, man, they run that place, man.
And that's what it do. And that's what it happens. That's what a part that Roman failed. They had so much, they occupied, they kept moving everywhere. They forgot their own home.
Huh.
You know? That's what's gonna bring the downfall of America soon.
That's what's happening to America. Like they send billions of dollars over to Israel every year, but here you still can't get clean water in Detroit and shit like that. They fucking themselves over. They helping support everybody else with their own people.
Yeah, in America. Fighting
everybody else freedom, but we still ain't got it here.
That's cool right there. So that angel was talking about a, you know, certain man, you know, Septimius Severus, and you can do your own research on him, you know.
It says,
which means his name basically means to cut. He cut through the empire, basically, you know. And when he got in there, and what he do? He brought his men. He brought his men. And just like what you do with anything, if you get a job, I tell this brother, look, man.